Welcome back to this clown's garage. In this video, I will be installing a tubular K member into this 1990 GTA. We've got tubular K member and tubular control arms. So first thing is we're putting the back wheels on blocks. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna jack it up from the control arm here a little high so I could put the jack stand over here. Do the same thing on the other side, put the jack stand on the other side of the frame rail. And then, once I have fairly enough to get this jack underneath the K-member, the stock K-member, then I'm going to jack it up all the way as much as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now.
Down?
Yep. Alright, now this is all jacked up. We put a jack over there just to have like a extra precautionary measure. And the car is really high up here. So we're gonna go ahead and start this project. Take off the bolts of the tire. Alright, first thing you do is take the end links off. There's a bolt that goes right through, so you gotta take the nut. And these are urethane ones. That's it, and the whole thing just comes right out. Oops. And you pop that end leak out. Make sure the order is the same because you have to put the bushings and the spacers and washers back in the same spot. Alright, now you're gonna have to pop the ball joint out. So take the cotter pin, straighten that bitch out, grab it from the other side. Let the dykes do all the work. Just twist it right out. Gotta love the dykes, baby. Alright, now pop this ball joint out. It's a 15/16. I already put some coil in there. Or you can put your favorite penetrant. Alright, now, gonna crack this loose. Just like that. Alright, this is very important. When you get to this point, make sure you have the nut on top still threaded in. Because you don't want that spring to pop out in your face and kill you.
Right there.
Now you don't care if you damage this ball joint because the kit comes with new ball joints. So we're going to go ahead and put a pickle fork in here and separate this ball joint loose. You can also spray some coil in here or your favorite personal lubricant. Alright, now put a jack underneath the ball joint. Jack this puppy up a little bit. Then you can take the nut off the ball joint stud. Then you could slowly release the jack down to release the tension in the spring. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. As you can see, as I pump it up, the stud goes up. So now you could actually turn it and take it off. Look, it's a castellated nut. How cute is that? It looks like a castle. Pop that shit out. Slowly. Release the tension and spring slowly. And that's it. No more tension in that spring, baby. Put a pry bar in there. Lower the jack some more. be careful when you do this. You gotta position this so you can actually pop it out. Now, since we're not taking the tie rod off, it's a little difficult here. And push this down very slightly, and while you're holding this up, just like that. Now push this down with your foot. Get the isolator come out with it. And that's how you take the shock, the spring out. Now I'm gonna take this bracket off that holds this brake line to the wheel well over here. That's a 13 millimeter bolt. Now I'm doing this because the brake line goes all along the K-member. So we're gonna drop the K-member slightly underneath so we could put our hands over there and loosen the hold downs that hold the brake line in place. So I'm just gonna take this off and do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so it's a 13 millimeter bolt. The other side, and that's it. All right, you see that wrench right there? It's 11/16. We're using a flare end, so we put it underneath the header like that. Now it's holding it in place. That's 11/16. On this side, this is a 16 millimeter, so I'm gonna go ahead and crack that loose. Got it?
Yep. Alright, that was a motor mount bolt, and now we're just gonna leave it there for now and loosen the other side.
Alright, now this motor mount here, it's very close to the the cooling line, excuse me. So we're gonna try to bend it with a pry bar over so we can fit a socket in there. Okay, now we have enough room to put a socket on there to zip that out.
Excellent.
That's the front of the car right here we're at. Make sure when you do that, it's not close to the harmonic balancer, it's not touching it. So we're good. Sorry. We have a 16 millimeter wrench on this side. And we're holding it through there. You can't really see, but
yeah.
On the other side of the mount. So now over here, I'm gonna put my impact gun. Just like that, and impact this out.
Got it?
Yep.
Yep.
And there she goes. Now I'm not gonna take the bolts out yet. All right, now I have a block of wood here, and we're just gonna jack it up to mate it with the oil pan. Just like that. Now we're gonna keep it there.
Okay, so now we're just pulling, now the motor's jacked up, we're gonna remove the motor mount bolts. There's the first one.
And the passenger side is right here. Just slide that right out.
All right, so we're gonna remove the top brake line bracket from the cross member. It's bolted to the cross member. It's a 10 millimeter bolt.
Now remember, we also unbolted the ones that go into the wheel well, so we have better access to take the middle bolt off the cross member, which we'll show you later. All right, we're gonna take these triangular braces now off the K-member, the bolt to the frame over here. Those are 15 millimeters. So I have a swivel on it, and there's two bolts on the K-member. And there she goes. All right, now do this side. this one here. And the last one here. Comes off just like that. Now these bolts, these two are different sizes than the front one, so make sure you put them back the same way. Yeah. All right, now the motor, the cam member bolts, there's two over here, and two on the other side, and one over there, and one on the other side. So I'm gonna take the first two that are close to each other first off on this side and the other side, then take the front off by itself. So, and these are 18 millimeter bolts. One, be careful, there's a sometimes there's water in here which sprayed all of us in the face. And now I'm gonna go do the other side. Now passenger side too. There's no water in this one. I don't know what to deal with that is. And the one in the back. All right, now we put a block of wood on the floor. And we put this jack stand right there to hold the cam member once it drops a little bit. So now I'm gonna go ahead and undo this last bolt up here. Remember, there's 6 bolts in total that hold this thing into the frame. Okay. And that's the last one. And you see how the jack stand caught it right there? That's what we want. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side.
Okay.
All right, now the last one here. And as you can see, the cam member is being held in place with these jack stands. So now we're gonna take the remaining brake lines off the cam member. All right, we got 10 millimeter ratcheting wrench here. Now remember, we dropped the cam member a little bit, so we get to the bolts here that hold the brake line in place. We put a one jack stand underneath. As you can see in there, that's where it is. Let's go this way. It's right above the cam member. I'm also going to show you how much this stock cam member weighs versus the tubular one that we're taking out. I mean, we're putting back in. Last one, right there. Alright, we have one more down here, which we missed. It's right over there. Came right off right there. That's the last bolt that's hold that brake line in place on the back over there. Now before you drop the whole thing, you take these out, the control arms, because you want this brake line to come off, and you can just pull it off to the side when you drop everything off. So 18 millimeter in the front, 18 millimeter in the back, put a box in on the other side, and zip this bad boy right off.
like that. Now the other side. And I'll do the other side. Now do this side.
You have to wiggle the arm a little bit.
Gotta wiggle and jiggle. Just like that. And now pop this bad boy out.
Nice.
Just like that. Now we're gonna take these clips off.
That's out. Now we have this. Gives a little extra room. Nice. I can bend the line.
And you do the same thing on the other side.
Perfect. Excellent.
Now do the other side.
There we go.
Okay. We got another bolt here. Right there, that holds the brake line in place. Ooh, okay. Careful it doesn't hit you in the face.
That's why we got the jack stand there.
For security. Jack stand took the brunt of that.
Okay. And the other side.
And one more on the other side. Yep. So money shot time. Hold this up, take the jack stand off, pop this belt on the side, and just wiggle it out. Just like that.
That's it, it's out.
And that's all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. Now that we have it off, we're going to take the motor mounts off. They're 18 millimeter bolts. And the last one over here. That's the motor mount. Take that side off the same way. Now one thing to remember, you gotta put these, there's a left side and a right side. If you don't put them in the right way, it's not gonna sit right. So make sure you mark which one's a passenger, which one's a driver's side, so you can put them back in the same spot. All right, now comes the weight. Mr. George here, let's step on a scale. See if he's been eating healthy on his healthometer. He's 205.
Okay.
Now with the stock control arm, he's gonna be hugging it. It's going to be 219.8. We got 220 before, so
yeah,
I would say 15 pounds.
15 pounds
for that control arm. So let's see what the UMI control arm, okay, tubular one weighs. That's the UMI control arm.
Okay, I can already feel it's lighter.
And we'll see what this weighs. So 220, this is 217.
Nah.
So it's 3 pounds lighter.
Mm-hmm.
So weight saving of 3 pounds.
Of unsprung mass, that's excellent.
Yes, that's on each side too.
That's right.
Let's try one more time. Make sure reading was correct.
Perfect.
Yep, 3 pounds. Let's see the K number now. All right, now we're just gonna weigh George by himself again.
Okay. So, of course, remember.
205.8.
Okay.
So now we took the motor mounts off, and it's just the bare K-member without the control arms. 250.
Spot.
Exactly.
Okay.
So that weighs 44 pounds. Now we're gonna do the tubular K-member.
UMI.
The UMI tubular K-member.
Okay. Put it in the same position.
He's bear hugging it. 230. So this, the K-member is 20 pounds lighter than the stock K-member. Just to recap real quick. George was 206, this with the stock K-member is 250. So it's the stock K-member weighs 44 pounds, the stock K-member. Then with the UMI K-member, he was 230. So that was 24 pounds with the UMI K-member that it weighed. Now these spring perches weigh 2 pounds each. So that's an extra 4 pounds we're putting on. So the K-member was 24 pounds, plus an extra 4 pounds for the two spring perches. That's 28 pounds for the tubular K-member with the spring perches. Versus the 44 pound stock K-member, it's a weight savings of 16 pounds. So, since the control arms were a savings of 3 pounds versus stock each, that's a net savings of 6 pounds total also for the control arms. So 6 pounds for the control arm savings and 16 plus 16 pounds for the K-member. That's a total of 22 pounds of savings versus stock for the front. Now you mount the motor mounts on the tubular K-member. These are 9/16 bolts with 9/16 nuts. It's a bolt, flat washer, and a lock washer underneath. So we're gonna go ahead and tighten those down. There's four and four. Putting antices on the bolts that go to the frame. You can go ahead and do all of them now, all six.
Good.
All right, now we're gonna mount this back on the car. These are spring perches. These go underneath over here and you put the bolts through it and holds it up. So you got these two bolts and one over here. If you're using coilovers, you don't need these, and you don't need the spring perches and the control arms. You just get the regular tubular ones without these, and it'll be lighter. And you can also use these with coilovers too if you want. So we're gonna go ahead and put this in the car now.
Yeah, this thing is so much easier to put on.
Alright, move it on this side and you take care of the brake line later. Just make sure the brake line is out of the way over here. The same way with the other side. Make sure the brake line is out of the way above this control arm area. So now that you have it in place, just put the back bolt in to hold it in. Hand tight. Tighten the back ones in, not all the way, just so it can hold the K-member up. That side?
Yeah.
Now you have to make sure the brake line's out of the way. Everything clears. There we go.
Okay.
All right, now we're just gonna make sure we're gonna mallet, hit it with the mallet very slightly. Just to line it up. This car has been hit a little bit. More than a little. So.
Okay, right about there.
All right, now we're gonna torque these three bolts down to 90 foot-pounds. We're gonna go twice, 145, go all the way around, then to 90 all the way around. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other five. Everything's torqued down to 45. I set the torque wrench to 90 and go ahead to 90 pounds. Now we're gonna tighten down the motor mounts.
Got it. Good.
We're good on this side. Now do the other side. Now do this motor mount. Passenger side. Okay. And that's done. Okay, now we're putting the braces in. They supply you with two brand new bolts. We're putting them in this way. And only one washer on this side. So these two new bolts here. And the stock bolt goes through there in the front. So once we have figured tight, we can tighten them down.
Okay. Not the best position. Okay.
And now we're going to the other side. We'll put a little wheel bearing grease on the sides over here on the control arm so it could slide in. Remember, lube makes everything better. It's all about the lube. And go ahead and put that on the car.
Alright.
Now we're putting the control arm in.
Okay. Okay. Get it a little smoother. Gotta get the bolts.
Gotta get the bolts, put the bolts in. Now this is the driver's side, and we moved the steering wheel all the way to the right, so we have clearance for this bolt to enter through here, so the tie rods are in the way. Okay. And we're gonna line up the other side first. Okay. And a smaller bolt goes towards the back of the car. And knock that in.
Yeah, a little more. There we go. Perfect.
Excellent. Like I always say, it's all about finding the hole.
Okay.
Now put the nut on the other side. Put a washer on this side, and a nut goes on the other side. That's a nylock they're giving you on the other side. It's a nylon lock nut.
And now the other side. Now normally you'd want to tighten this down, loaded, but these are free floating, these bushings, so it doesn't matter. So now we're gonna put the spring in. Now one thing about the spring, it's very, very dangerous when you do this on the ground like this, because you're putting a lot of pressure and you have to squeeze it in here. I'll show you what we're doing, but I would recommend a normal person doing this on their car by themselves. It's very, very dangerous. I'll show you what I mean right now.
The isolator, I'm gonna tape it over here. You'd want to tape this because it's gonna move around up there. And if you don't tape it, this comes off, you're gonna hear creaking when you're driving around, so you don't want that. You can put one here and one here and you should be fine.
I'm gonna put a little lube on the spring perch on the control arm, just so the spring could pop in a little easier. Any little butter sauce will help out the situation right now. Now this is probably better to do with little spring compressors on the side to compress the spring a little bit. It'll probably go in much easier. But this is how you do it if you don't have a spring compressor. Now over here, there's a little bump right there. The end of the coil should sit right there. That's how you index the spring. See right there? That's the end of the coil. It should sit right there. If you don't index that properly, the car's gonna be sitting higher on one side than the other. So you have to index that. I'm gonna go insert that bitch. Have to pop in over there with the perches. All right, so here, as you can see, we put the pry bar between that coil over there and the control arm. Now that's how the pry bar is. Now I'm gonna go ahead and jack this up. We're gonna jack it up so the edge is hitting here. We don't wanna hit the fitting. As he's prying it from over there, I'm gonna be jacking it up. So we have that pry bar wedge in there so that spring doesn't pop out too. It's going in there. Oops. Okay. Go ahead. But surely it's gonna go. Like I said, I would recommend this. Is very dangerous. Now it's a loaded bomb right there.
Okay. There we go.
And it's getting closer. This is a real bitch, but we almost got it right there. We have a little bit to go.
Okay, now we'll do what we did before. And get this over here.
I'll do the same thing here. Okay. One guy underneath with a pry bar.
Actually, let me do this hole.
He wants to do that hole. You can have that hole. Double team, baby.
Okay.
now. It's above the per.
And I think we got it. It's a combination of feet leverage on one side and pry bar on the other. It's almost in. It's almost in.
There it is.
It's almost in.
There it is. Watch for the bang.
The money shot, money shot.
Home, home. Watch.
Need a big, need a heavier hammer.
Yeah. Watch, it's gonna bang right in.
Pop.
There it goes.
There she goes. She's in, baby. That's how you do it. Now, you gotta compress the shock a little bit to pop that bitch right in.
Check it out.
Now just jack it up. There we go. Now put the nut on, tighten it down, put the cotter pin through, and tap it. So she wrote, baby. All right, so we hand tighten the nut above the ball joint stud. And now we're just greasing it down a little bit before there's any tension on it in the ball joint. Now you see the hole again. Put the cotter pin through. Now go ahead and grease it up the rest until you see the rubber boot bulging a little bit. It just bulged, so we're good. And now we're gonna grease the control arm bushings right here. You can do it until you slightly see some grease coming out of the sides, or you just do a couple of pumps and you should be fine. So we're just gonna go ahead and do that now. Put the stabilizer bar link on. The end link. Alright, so we put that bolt back in. Put the bracket in. Best way to do that is just to catch the bolt first without the bracket in its place. And once you do that, you can just go ahead and put the bracket in place. So I'm just gonna tighten that down. Alright, now put this back in. Put the clip in. And whack that bitch in place. You gotta put her into place sometimes, you know? The way they like it. It's good.
Okay, that's it.
Alright, so we're just zip tying the brake line to the K-member, that's all.
Okay.
On there. Just go around and we're gonna see what needs zip ties and zip tie it. Make sure the brake line's out of the way from everything, that's all. We're gonna cut the ends and that's it over here. Alright, now you see they give you shims here. They give you thicker shims and these are the smaller, the thinner shims. And these are 4mm Allen headed bolts and they screw right here. And now what you gotta do here is you put a tire on. And you move it back and forth and make sure there's enough clearance because these are the stops for the tires over here, for the wheels. It hits right here. So if you have clearance issues and you need more space here for the tire to clear, let's say a brake line or whatever it is, then you put a thicker shim here, which is provided with the kit. So now we're just going to tighten this down. Yeah, so we're good. Alright, so we're done, guys. This is what it looks like, all said and done. Everything's bolted down, nothing's in the way, everything clears, brake lines are out of the way, and now we have enough room for the twin turbo that's going in this car, which will also be documented on my channel. Yep, heard that right, twin turbo, and his GTA. So thanks for watching, subscribe to my channel, remember, if this clown could do it, so can you. Like me, share me, do whatever you want to me. Toodles!